Here are the facts of my case. We applied for a 501c4 in October 2010. Our $850 application fee was cashed 7 days later. We received a letter from Robert Cho dated November 2nd, 2010, stating that our application and our user fee payment had been received. It also stated that we should be expecting to hear from someone within 90 days. However, the IRS did not initiate any contact with us for another 459 days. That was when I received a letter from the Cincinnati office dated February 3rd, 2012. That letter stated that they could not process our application until we completed the enclosed questionnaire, which requested approximately 90 pieces of additional information about our organization. The questionnaire stated that if the additional information was not returned by February 24th, our case would be closed. The demands for information in the questionnaire shocked me as someone who loves liberty and the First Amendment. I was asked to hand over my donor list, including the amounts that they gave and the dates on which they gave them. 501c4 organizations do not have to disclose donor information. I knew that. Why don't they? Among the demands that I found alarming and inappropriate were, they wanted me to identify all of my volunteers. They wanted to know if any of our donors or volunteers had run or would be running for office in the near future. Remember, this is the 2012 election cycle. They wanted us to identify the office they would be running for. They wanted us to provide detailed contents of all speeches ever given, the names of our speakers and their credentials. They wanted copies of written communications and contents of all other forms of communications to any legislative body, including my own representative. I was very uncomfortable with these questions, as you can imagine, and my husband and I discussed forfeiting our application. However, within days of reading through these questions, we knew we were being targeted because fellow Tea Party organizers across this nation were getting the same types of letters and questionnaires. That was when we decided to seek legal counsel. On March 6, 2012, we retained the counsel of the American Center for Law and Justice, and they represented us in this matter. 2 weeks later, I received a letter from Lois Lerner, dated March 16, 2012, asking that I provide the previously requested information. 4 months later, we received a letter dated July 9, 2012, stating that we had been approved to receive our tax exemption. This was 635 days after we applied. In conclusion, the Wetumpka Tea Party filled out a complete application. Our organization fell within the boundaries of receiving a 501c4 status. Yet, our application was singled out solely because we had Tea Party in our name. Government agents made invasive and excessive demands for information they were not entitled to. Congressman Camp and members of this committee, this was not an accident. This is a willful act of intimidation to discourage a point of view. What the government did to our little group in Wetumpka, Alabama, is un-American. It isn't a matter of firing or arresting individuals. The individuals sought to intimidate us were acting as they thought they should in a government culture that has little respect for its citizens. Many of the agents and agencies of the federal government do not understand that they are servants of the people. They think they are our masters, and they are mistaken. I'm not interested in scoring political points. I want to protect and preserve the America that I grew up in, the America that people cross oceans and risk their lives to become a part of. And I'm terrified it is slipping away. Thank you.
Thank you very much.